everybody, Wyatt-Andrews-Workshop here, and welcome back to the second episode of our little Southeast Asian adventure with the new pack that came out a couple days ago. Today we're going to focus on some of the more tree-dwelling species we got in this pack, besides the binturong, which we put at the front. So just a little reference as to where we are in the zoo, or the section specifically. Here's the dole exhibit from last episode, and we just continued this trail all the way over here. And then we haven't really done anything with the elephant yard yet. That'll probably be for the end of the series. But I'm torn between either Babirusa or Komodo dragon for this little area. Or I might just leave it empty, who knows. I kind of want this to be like really big and sprawling and kind of exploratory. So we might like really spread out the exhibits. So yeah, this is the sort of canopy trail. Here's one of the signs I borrowed from the Point Defiant Zoo. I just changed the title, didn't change the text, and then added some new images. We got like this gibbon and the hornbill, which are a couple spoilers as to what we have going on in here. So let's make our way in. First, we have the clouded leopard exhibit. Let me press play because this guy actually likes to climb around a lot. We have the clouded leopard exhibit. You'll notice like all of these are very like simple, large cages for these more climbing type animals, arboreal. And I'm thinking like this whole section was built in like the late 80s, early 90s. So I'm taking a lot of cues from the monkey trails and forest tales section of the San Diego Zoo, which was built around the same time, as, if I remember correctly. So yeah, here's their sign, you know, same template as the others. And then, we'll actually go inside. So they have a nice little hammock. This isn't the actual enrichment piece. It's just the Indian fabric piece. I just colored it uniform. I think it works great if you don't have any room for the actual enrichment item, and you just want to toss in some like more variation among your climbing structures. Where is that guy? He's fast asleep. I really, really love the model for this one. This is probably, next to the proboscis monkey and the Babirusa, is probably my favorite model in this pack. Like, it's gorgeous. It might be my favorite big cat model in the game, because the others kind of leave a lot to be desired. But, yeah. Oh, there you go. Wakey, wakey. Attaboy. So yeah, this is like their kind of private area, even though it's still technically part of the main yard. It's really cool to see them actually come up here and utilize all the climbing stuff I built for them, which he's doing right now. Let's check that out. And you'll notice right here, the like jumping is like in slow motion for some weird reason. He tried. Do it, come on. Oh. He's working on it. There you go. Yeah, the jumping is in like slow motion for some reason, but it's really cool to see them actually use this stuff. Just because like I sort of cut off the two halves of the exhibit, so they have to climb to get from point A to point B. And it's very janky, but I see a lot of people complain about this, the climbing structures in the game and the climbing animations, but like, I'm from Zoo Tycoon 2, I'm a Zoo Tycoon veteran, so like, just seeing them use anything in their exhibit is just like a shock to the system. And like, even if it is a little janky sometimes, like, I really can't be bothered. Like, it's so cool to just see them use the things you make, you know? I don't know, that's just me. So over here we have the CLAWS, or the Clouded Leopard Analysis Station. It's just a research station, but I wanted the acronym to sound cooler. And then we have this really neat sign we got from the new DLC. It's like, it almost has like a vectorized quality. It looks like they actually painted it onto the side of the building. It's really cool. So, oh wait, let me adjust the lighting, because it looks really cool at like 6 a.m. Because it's like almost morning, but like still dark. Like, look at that. That's nuts. It's gorgeous. I love it. So yeah, this is the Clouded Leopard Analysis Station. Over here we have our second exhibit, or our second like exhibit area, because this is actually a rotational cage. So today we have a couple female proboscis monkeys in here. Maybe there was like some social issue that rose up, so they had to move them in here. Oh, hey. Yeah, so it's definitely on the smaller side, but it's obviously temporary. But the like sort of gimmick with this one is it's themed to like a research base camp. So you have all these crates and these tables and this tent. It probably shouldn't be lit up, but it looks much more convincing in the daytime. And they would like make sure like everything was like monkey proof, just so they wouldn't like rip it apart. They'd probably do something with that tent just to make sure like they couldn't dismantle it. But again, it's a temporary exhibit, so it's definitely gonna be on like the jankier side. And then over here we have our three terrariums. I'm just pretending these guys are Southeast Asian wildlife. I think the scorpion might be, but the cockroach is Australian and the frog is South American. But I really don't feel like making custom signs for all these terrarium creatures just because I just don't feel like it. And then moving over here, we have, I think this is supposed to be like either a tiger skull or like a saber-toothed cat skull of some kind, just for like comparison. And then over here, we have another viewing into the clouded leopards exhibit. Just jumping in slow motion again, and he changed his mind. But this this little setup for the exhibit walls was directly ripped from the Lost Forests. It's sort of like a little mini reptile house inside of that area, and this sort of like layout is directly ripped from it. Then moving into the second room of the analysis station, you have a larger window into the clouded leopards, and then you have your first view into the silvery lutung exhibit. Lutungs are just a type of langur monkey that's found in Southeast Asia. I was gonna put capuchins in here just as like a little replacement, but I forgot. That's okay. There's probably gonna be a couple implied exhibits throughout the zoo. And then over here we have, this is supposed to be like a transport cage for like field research, or either like a trap cage. So like in the field, they would either like tempt the leopards in here, or this is what they use to like put them back into the wild. So you just lift this up and they go running out. So just like a couple like extra little details of theming, in addition to like all these hammocks and all these crates and carpets. It's supposed to feel like a little ramshackle, but so like professional. So this was kind of a confusing thing for me because there's a door on this side, right? But then this one just opens up completely, and that is not good design because this area would definitely snow. This zoo is set in Iowa, so the snow would just come flooding through here. So I have no idea how I'm supposed to fix this because I've made the path first and I'm not able to like move this entire building to the right. So, you know, we'll see what we can do. It's probably not that hard and I'm just being lazy, but whatever. Okay, so moving out of the research station and up the trail, you get actually a really neat view into the elephant exhibit and the rest of the area. I think it'll look really cool once I have an exhibit here and we can peer into whatever's down there. And then moving through, the lighting's actually perfect. Look at that. This is definitely one of my favorite vistas in the area, just because the lighting, the way it bounces off the plants and leads you into the other exhibits is beautiful. So this is the Siamang exhibit. Here's their sign. I had to use an actual photo of a Siamang because we don't have them in the game, unfortunately. I feel like gibbons would be really hard to program just because if they're not brachiating, it looks off. And yeah, this one's definitely more vertically inclined just because these guys really like to go nuts and swing around. And I had bonobos in here just because they kind of look like Siamangs. They like have the same color and like the same kind of flashy hairdos, but they really weren't using this at all. So I just figured it kind of made me sad to see these great apes in a cage like this. So I just took them out, even though I like had like a food area and a water area for them, which you can't really see from here, so it looks fine. And then here's like the official view into the lutung exhibit. Here's their sign. Again, no lutung in the game, so just have to use a real photo, unfortunately. But yeah, this is like a little more obscured just because you already got your big window view into their habitat, so this one is a little less revealing. And then moving into like the sort of second e-ticket attraction. Oh, before we go into that, I wanted to point this out. I thought this was really cool how you can kind of get like a little peek into the into all this backstage, which I will fill out more in the future. But for now, it's like a nice little like immersion breaker. All right, and then we'll adjust the lighting again. And we'll take this guy out of his crate. Come on, buddy, we're doing a show. Cooperate here. There we go. Oh, okay. Come on, dude, you're spoiling it. You're ruining it. There you go. Good boy. So this is the proboscis monkey passage exhibit. There's two cages and a little bridge between them, which Lion made like the base for this. And here's their sign. Thankfully, we do actually have them in the game. So there we go. And we'll just unbox all these guys because it's obviously a very complicated exhibit, which Frontier does not like, or not Frontier, Planet Zoo does not like. So they get boxed all the time. And yeah, the crossing doesn't really work the best, but they do it and they're able to traverse it. So, you know, it works. Usually what they do is like they end up on top of this thing and then they just like go halfway and leap to the other side, which is like neat, but I wish they would just do it normally, but you know, whatever. I really love how this came out and how all of these cages came out. If you zoom out, it looks gorgeous from above, just seeing all the little sort of mesh structures sort of popping out of the forest canopy. And these are all made out of the, let's see what item this is. The New World Fence Post 3. I think it looks great from like really any distance, not so much up close, but you aren't really getting up close, so it's fine. I think it blends in with the wire mesh fence really well. And could one of these guys climb for the camera? I don't know. We'll ramble until one of them does. I think they're all on this side. Let's look at the model in the meantime. I think it's gorgeous. Like, look at that. They nailed it. Like, looking at a real proboscis monkey, they absolutely nailed it. Where are you going? Oh, there you go. I've never seen them like use this log, but let's check out the climbing animation. So yeah, they start on the bridge and then they go on top, and then they're staying on top. I feel like people would be panicking. Yeah, you see that? They just go halfway and then leap to the other side. Oh, there he goes. It's super janky, but I don't really mind as long as they're using it. And then we have this super cute little minimalistic proboscis monkey sign that we got in the update. I've heard a lot of people don't like this, but I really love it. I don't really have a super practical use for it. What are you doing? Go back in your cage. There you go. God, this is so janky. Why can't you just be normal? And yeah, that was pretty much all we have so far. As you can see, we have this going on. This will be like an aviary row. So this is where we'll have the hornbills, maybe a Philippine eagle. I don't know if they have those in captivity. I'll do some research, but this is where all the birds are going to be. And it'll be like this super steep trail all the way down here. And I've made it accessible up until this point, so we're just going to have an elevator that comes all the way down if you don't really want to use the stairs. And yeah, I'm super excited to continue this. We just recorded another episode of Gold Coast Aquarium, so we'll have that out in the nick of time. And I also have another surprise video for you guys, which I think you'll really enjoy. So stay tuned, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.